Hello guys, this is Indian Medico and in this video we are going to see about fetal circulation before the birth of a baby and the changes that take place in fetal circulation during the time of birth. This is a concise presentation for medical students. Remember, the term fetal circulation encompasses the entire fetoplacental circulation. Fetal circulation works differently from normal postnatal circulation. This is mainly because the lungs are not in use in case of fetal circulation. Remember, the fetus obtains oxygen and nutrients from mother through the placenta and umbilical cord. Now let us see about fetal circulation before birth in detail. Oxygen-rich blood enters the fetus from the maternal circulation through the umbilical vein. Remember, in this case, a vein carries oxygenated blood. Okay, blood in the umbilical vein then goes to the liver. Remember, a fetal liver is not yet fully developed, so it doesn't require much blood supply. So the blood here is bypassed through a structure called ductus venosus and it enters the inferior vena cava. That is, much of the blood doesn't enter the liver and it directly drains into the inferior vena cava through the ductus venosus. A small amount of blood enters the liver and it is drained into the inferior vena cava through the portal vein. So the blood in the inferior vena cava is still very much oxygenated. After this, the blood in the inferior vena cava goes to the right atrium. There is a structure called foramen ovale between the right atrium and left atrium. Blood goes to the left atrium from the right atrium through the foramen ovale. After this, the blood goes to the aorta and supplies the entire body. In the right atrium, some amount of blood can go to the right ventricle and this blood can enter into the pulmonary artery. Remember, in case of fetus, the lungs are filled with fluid. So the pressure in the pulmonary system is high. So blood in the pulmonary artery is directed to the aorta through a structure called ductus arteriosus. As told earlier, the blood in the aorta will supply the various parts of the fetus. The deoxygenated blood from various parts of the fetus are collected by the umbilical artery and then they reach the maternal circulation. Now, what are the changes that take place in fetal circulation during birth? Remember, these changes are because the umbilical cord is clamped and the baby no longer receives oxygen and nutrients from the mother. The most important change with the first breath of life is that the lungs begin to expand and there is no more fluid in the lungs. Okay, after birth, the following changes take place. There will be closure of umbilical arteries. The distal umbilical artery becomes umbilical ligaments and the proximal part remains as superior vesical arteries. There will be closure of umbilical veins. The remnant is ligamentum teres. There will be closure of ductus venosus and the remnant is ligamentum venosum. There will be closure of ductus arteriosus and its remnant is ligamentum arteriosum. There will also be closure of foramen ovale. Thus, the circulation becomes like that of an adult system. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. If you like this video, please like, share, subscribe, and tell your friends about this channel. Thank you.